all that's left to wrap up here in Dubna is the most spectacular discipline of them all, the sting in the tail. This is the jump.
It can be a bit scary, you know, you've got to try and leave it as late as possible and, you know, try and gather that speed into the ramp. And, you know, any little rollers in front of the ramp can be a little scary, but you've got to try and cut through them and, you know, just get your lift off the jump.
You know the danger involved, so the adrenaline's just pumping and then you get that release and it's just like, yes.
When you come off, it just all happens so quick that as long as your skis are up in front of you, that's just the enjoyment. You start to lean out over the skis and then if you keep climbing, then your heart really starts going because you know it's huge.
It's just like a sensation of getting pulled off the ramp and you just get that speed in the end. You know it's a big jump. That's more... It's just like a really nice feeling. It's the best feeling you can have.
Well, time now for highlights of the jump final as we once again join Desmond Kennedy.
So it is jump time. Here comes Maria Vimbranetseva from Greece. It's a whopper, 48-1, a jump number one. In fact, that's the best of the set for the lady from Greece. Natalia Bertnikova from Belarus. She is in winning form today. Listen to the crowd cheer. That's a beautiful jump. And the judges say it's 49-2. Can you believe it? Okay, she decided to pass on jump number three, taking 49-2 back to the dock. Stand aside, folks. Here is the world jump champion. That was jump number two. She passed on jump number one. Oh, huge pressure. The world jump champion has got herself into a real fix. She's got one jump remaining, no score on the board. Ah, oh, that's more like it. The judges like it too. Distance 48.2 meters. Well, that's all June Gladborg, European Masters Champion, Roomba Masters Champion has to do. She's got to do anything better than 48.2. No, can you believe it? 47.4. Oh, what a shock. From the Lady Champagne, back with the Texan, Ryan Fitz. He's got 64, he's got a 60, he needs a big one on jump number three. And he's got it, listen to the roar, 66.1 meters. Aurelien Sirot of France, can he do any better? Big kick off the top of the ramp. Uh-oh, 61.5, that won't do it. Mark Lane, the biggest 5'6" jumper in the world, on the lower ramp, can he do it on the big one? No, 61.5, that's not enough. Well, surely the Canadian, as he comes in now on jump number two, Jared Llewellyn, big crowd, popularity roaring in the background, jump number two. Let's take a look. No, no, that doesn't look right. No, no, 52.1. He had 58.6 on jump number one. Here comes jump number three. He needs a big one here. He needs to get right up over 65 meters, kicking. Oh, that's it. Yes, 66.5.
It was like on the last one, I said, what the heck, you know, I'm going to come sixth or I'm going to get a big one. And I bit off a bit out of the turn too much, and coming across the wake, I thought, I'm going to have a hard time kicking. And I just dropped my head and couldn't believe my legs straight. So lucky, and I was hoping it was a little bit farther because Brady's coming out and he banged off a 68 pretty easy. So I don't think it'll last, but I'm happy. I'm ecstatic about tricks. Maybe I have to buy some drinks tonight.
Well, is this the year for Great Britain athlete Jason Seals? He can jump over 70 meters. 63.8. That won't do it. Jaron's the lead with 66.5. Here comes Freddy Krueger. It looks like a whopper. Oh, can you believe it? It's 66. He's half a meter short. His last attempt. Can he get better than 66.5? It's going to be a tough call. It might not be Freddy Krueger's big day. Oh, can you believe it? 66.6. He's just done it.
Jared didn't have much on the table there after his first two jumps, but he's a veteran. And he's a great jumper, and so he pulled out that big jump. I thought my first one was farther. I thought I maybe had it on the first one, and thought I missed it on the last one. So it just shows that, you know, you got to wait till the numbers come up.
So a great end to an action-packed day here in Dubna in Russia. Round two of the Waterski World Cup takes us to Egypt. Join us there soon.